Good morning, guys. In the previous class, we were discussing about these program blocks. See, I told you two terms there actually, program blocks and one more term was control sections. That control sections we will see in the next topic. So once again, let me to revise this program block. Then we will go to next portions of this same program blocks. Because in the previous class, only just a brief introduction I had given, okay? See, program blocks are nothing but in a same program, in an entire program, there may be some subroutines. It means that program can be divided into multiple number of parts. But these all parts together, we will treat it as a single unit or single program. Okay, when we convert this single program into machine level language or low level language, then we will call it as a single object program. For one source program, we will generate one object program. Okay, so even though that source program contains multiple number of parts, okay, or blocks, we will generate only one object program, remember. But in a control section, what happens? In control sections, there are multiple parts are there in the same program. For each and every part of that program, we are going to generate that many number of different separate object programs. So this is the main difference. So in object program, already you know, header record we should write, text record and end record. If required, we will write a modification record also, right? So same object program, what we write for different parts, then it is called as a control sections. This is the main difference. So control sections we will discuss after the completion of this program blocks. Let's just focus on now program blocks, okay? Here, in a previous class, I told you one program I had shown you in page number 81. Okay, in page number 81 of your textbook, there is a program is there in figure 2.11. Okay, so in this figure, in line number 5, a program is started and this is the beginning of the program. Okay, so in the beginning of the program, if you don't have any use statement, okay, capital letter use, if you don't have any use statement, then use is nothing but it is assembler directive, okay? So if you don't have any use statement, then automatically you should understand that this program or this block belongs to a default block, okay? Remember that block is called as default block. If it is unnamed there, unnamed means use statement is not used. Okay, use assembler directive is not written there, and if it is not written along with the name of that block, then we should automatically understand that is a unnamed block, and I will call it as a default block. Okay, it is treated as a default block, and in the entire program, again, if you don't have any use statements or use assembler directive in your program, suppose, then you can treat the entire program is belonging to this default block only, okay? It means that if your program does not contain any, at least any single use statement, use assembler directive, then you should think or you should understand that by default, the whole program, the entire all set of statements belong to this default block, okay? So if in your program somewhere, use statement is appeared, suppose, okay? For example, in your page number 81, in that diagram, in that program, in line number 92, use statement is appeared now. So this use assembler directive is appeared with one operand name there. That operand name is a C data. That C data is nothing but it is in the place of operand, okay? It is in the place of operand of your source program, that is third column, right? So this C data is nothing but it is a name of that second block. First block was a default block, okay? So second block is C data. And again, in line number 103, in line number 103, you will find out one more use statement with the operand or with the block name C blocks. So in an entire program of page number 81, we have three blocks: default block, C data block, and C blocks, okay? So, but once again, if any use statement is appear, that use statement is also used, or it also indicates the continuation of any previously used blocks. Okay, suppose if you want to again after C block, if you want to continue or resume the default block, you can use the statement use assembler directive without operand name, because it is a default block is not containing any name, particular name. So it is unnamed block. So because of that only in line number 123, in line number 123, I used one assembler directive in your page number 81. Okay, in line number 123, I used one assembler directive use statement without any operand. What it indicates? It indicates that the default block is once again started to continue, or it is continued, or it is it resumed. Okay. Okay. Then in line number 183, in line number 183, once again you have a use statement, but this time you have on operand name. That operand name is nothing but it is a block name that is called as C data. It means already in previous line number 103, before 103, in line number 100, that C data was completed, but in line number 183, once again it is going to start. In line number 183, C data is continued or resumed. So again in line number 208, use statement is used without any operand or block name. What it indicates? It indicates the C default block is again resumed or continued. Again in line number 252, again I have used one use statement with the operand name or block name as a C data. It means it is indicating that C data is resumed. Like this, one block is stopped somewhere and again it is continued or resumed in some other part of your program like this. Okay, so in an entire program we have three blocks here: default block, C data block, and C blocks. Okay, so these are not continuously written in my program. So first default block is there, then C data is there, then C block is there, and again resumed that default block, then again C data, again C data, like this. Okay, so instead of writing our program like this, assembler, what it does, assembler will rearrange this program logically. Rearrange this program means in a default block, what it is containing, in default block it is containing some executable statements. Okay, so if you observe carefully, in default block, in default block it is containing executable statements, right? So here I have written, see here, in a default block it contains executable instructions or executable statements. In a in the second block, that is in C data, what is there? Data areas are there. Okay, data areas are nothing but the data constants which are related to memory or address, which are using or referring a memory or address. So these data areas are using very few words or very few bytes. So for example, these data constants, already you know how we can generate these data constants by using assembler directive byte or word, or else reserve word or reserve byte. So like this, we have four assembler directives. So these four assembler directives will generate the data constants or data areas, and particularly in C data, the data areas, whatever we are finding, these data areas are very, very short. These are using a very less number of words or very less number of bytes. It may be 3 bytes or else it may be 1 word of length only. Okay, in particularly in C data, we are making a group of data areas which are using less amount of memory. And in the third block, C blocks, again we are using a data areas, but these data areas are using a large amount of memory. Okay, larger blocks of memory. So sir, why we are going to do the like this, this division and all those things, the reason we will see it later. Okay, don't worry right now why it is divided like this. Okay, so but here the problem with this assembler is when default block is going to start and when it is going to complete and when again it is going to resume. Okay, instead of getting these all confusions, this assembler wants a block continuously, sequentially. So once that default block completes, so then only it starts to write the second block, that is C data. And again, after the completion of C data block or second block, then only it starts the third block. So like this it will arrange according to its convenient, okay? But whatever the addresses you are assigning to these all blocks here, these all statements here in your program in the location column, so these all will not affect on your object program. In object program, however, your actual source program was there originally in the same order, in the same sequence, you will generate or you will write the object program. So whatever this assembler is logically rearranging the blocks, it will not affect on our object program. Don't worry. Okay. So here, this assembler, how it will rearrange these all things? To do these all things, as you already familiar with the pass one algorithm and pass two algorithm. So assembler will use pass one algorithm and pass two algorithm, and it will rearrange these all blocks. So already I told you what is the summary of pass one. What exactly we do or assembler will do in pass one? In pass one, we just define the symbol. It means we will keep on assigning the addresses to the symbols or labels or operands. Okay. So in pass two, what we do? In pass two, we actually translate the assembly level program or instructions into object program, that is object code we will generate in a pass 2. Okay, these pass 1 and pass 2 will be used by this assembler to organize or to rearrange these all blocks. So at that time during pass 1, what this assembler will does is, this assembler will use 3 blocks are there, right? For each block, it will use 3 different location counter variables. Okay, so for each block, it will use separate and different location counter variable. So for example, for default block, it will use one location counter and it will initialize its value to a 0. It means, so every block, it will assume that every block will start or begin in the address 0. So every block contains a location counter and it is initialized to 0. And of course, in your block, if you have next instructions, according to the length of that instruction, you will keep on increment or keep on increase the value of location counter. And once the pass one algorithm will be completed, at the end of the pass one algorithm, if you look into the values of these 3 location counter variables, the recent value or latest value of a location counter, the latest value or recent value of location counter will give you the length of that particular block. Okay, so obviously the recent value or latest value of location counter will give us the length of that block default, block C data, and block C block. Okay, so 3 different blocks are there, 3 different location counters are there, and the recent values of this location counter will give you the lengths of those blocks. Okay, so whenever the location counter is keep on incrementing, and suddenly if a second block started, at that time, the before jumping to that second block, the location counter will save the previous block's recent value of location counter, so that it doesn't know again when that default block will resume or it will continue. So once that resumes, our default block, if it resumes in somewhere in the next part of your program, again that previous saved block, saved value was there, no, that is address, that address will be again continued in the next resume or next block, okay, which is once again started. So for example, if you want to show this, I will show you it in a page number 83. Okay, you come to page number 83. In page number 83, in figure 2.12, you have once again the same program, but this time you have that same program without comment lines, but instead of comment lines here, we have generated a object codes here. Okay, so object codes we have generated, and we have also written location column here. If you observe, we have written location column, and apart from location column, we have written one more column here, that is a block column. What it is indicating? Block is indicating the number of block, because for each block we are assigning one number here, like a register number or roll number. For every block we are assigning a number here. So as I told you, default block is unnamed block. So here I am giving a number to that default or unnamed block. That number is a 0. So it is starting in the line number 5, and that default block is stopping temporarily in the line number 70. And from line number 92 onwards, here block number is 1 is here. So what is this block number 1? The block number 1 is nothing but your C data block, okay, C data. So in line number 92, C data is started here. And again, it is closed or stopped temporarily in line number 100. And from line number 103, there is a third block, that is a C block. Because of that only here I have written use C blocks. Okay, this is how we are writing or we are giving the numbers to these blocks. Okay, default block number is 0, C data block number is 1, C blocks program block number is 2. And if you observe the address of a C default block, it is ending in line number 70 and its address is 0024. So this 0024 value of location counter will be saved when that location counter start to save a new value, okay, that is 0000. So this 0024 will continue once again when that default block will resume, okay, or that default block will continue. So why it is 24 and why it is 27 here? Because here J instruction is there, which whose length is a 3 bytes. So 24 plus 3, then it becomes 27 here. Again, because here you are resuming the default block. Again, it will be keep on continuing like this. And when you come to once again the use statement with the C data, it means the continuation of the C data block. Here its address is 0006. Why it is 0006? Because if you go back and if you observe previous C data block, here it was stopped in the address 0003 and here its length is one word, reserve word. How many number of words it is reserving? One word. One word is equal to 3 bytes. So plus 3, then it will become 0006. After that, here 006 is there. If this C data again continues in next portion of your program, you can come here. Of course, it is starting again, resuming here. And here it became 0007. Why? Because here byte is there. Byte is reserving how many number of bytes? 1 byte. So 006 plus 1, then it becomes 7. And then in the next line also it is 7. And next it is becoming A. Why it is A? Because here one literal is there. One literal, and it is particularly a character constant. A character constant EOF. And for E, there is a 1 byte. For O, there is 1 byte, and for F, there is 1 byte. So 3 byte character constant it is. So if you add 3 to 7, then you will get 000A. Okay. So here, after 000A, once again, one more literal is there, that is hexadecimal constant, that is X05, which will reserve 1 byte of memory. Okay, so because of that only here you can write here. I have not written here, author also not written. Actually, you can write here, no problem. So 000B. After A, if you add 1, then it will become 000B. Okay, so sir, why you are telling here even though it is not here? Because it is required in your object program or in the next topic. So I am telling you. So this is a 000B here. And if you resume your default block in line number 208 here, okay, its a previous block was stopped in the address 004A. So after that, if you add 3, because R sub instruction is assembled or converted here by using 3 byte, okay, that is third format, format number 3. Okay, because of that only, if you add 3 here, it will become 4D. So like this, based on the length of these instructions, you will keep on adding the bytes to your location counter. Then it becomes 0063. Okay, last address of a default block is 0063. And once again here, which instruction is there? That is R sub is there. Again, it is assembled with using a format number 3. So it means it is using 3 bytes. So length of R sub instruction is 3 bytes. So once again, if you add plus 3 to this one, then it will become 0066. Okay, remember, similarly, if you talk about C blocks, so this C blocks is only one time it is appearing in an entire program. It is not stopping and resuming, stopping and resuming like other blocks like default and C data. This is appeared only once in your entire program. Okay, if you want, you observe that. So this block also was started in the address 0, and its length is how much here? Its maximum length itself is 1000, because it is stopped here only. Again, this block is not resumed somewhere else and it is not continued. Location counter value is not continued. Okay, just remember the length of this C block is what here? It is 1000 only. Okay, how this is 1000? I already told you in previous class, buff and address you will find, you find out and you subtract it with the buffer, then you will get it as a 1000. If you want, you can see here only. So buff end is 1000 here and buffer is 0, 1000 minus 0, then it is again 1000 here. So this 1000 is a length of the block, third block, that is C block. Okay, so you just remember these all things. And one more thing I want you to do today is a homework. It is a assignment. Here in this particular page, page number 83, there are object codes are here. Okay, in rightmost column, I want you to generate these all object codes today, and you have to send these object codes to me, okay, by cross checking with this textbook. One small change will be here, because already you have generated a object code for SIC and SIC XE machine. One small change is there. What is that change? I tell you, based on that you have to generate the object codes. Okay, so that change is only one example I will show you, and the remaining thing you have to do here. Okay, and before that I wanted to tell you one more thing is see here, I just told you assembler will rearrange these all blocks by using pass one algorithm and pass two algorithm. So before going to that, let me to explain you how this pass one and pass two algorithms will rearrange the blocks, that is program blocks. Okay, so nothing is there. This is an algorithm for pass one to rearrange the blocks, which will be done by the assembler. Don't worry, no need to be panic, because the algorithm is very, very similar to your pass one algorithm, what is already familiar with you. Okay, so this is just a small minute changes are there. Yeah, that's all. So first begin, okay, begin, and block number is equal to 0. I am assigning a block number to a block. Okay, so I think you understood already. Block number is equal to 0, it means sir is talking about the block number 0, means he is talking about default block. Okay, so then location counter of I is equal to 0. Here I is indicating nothing but it is a block number. It is a, suppose if it is block number is 0, you count it a location counter of 0. Location counter of 0 is equal to 0 is nothing but that block is started in the address 0. Okay, and this 0 assigning to this location counter is not only for a default block, it is for all blocks. Okay, it is for C data block also, it is for C block block also. So because of that only here we have written it is for all I. I is nothing but here block number. It is indicating block number. And read the first input line from your block. And if opcode is equal to start, the same points, same lines, same method, what already you have written for pass one algorithm. Okay, I hope you are already practiced pass one and pass two, because any one of them will definitely be asked in your question paper. Either pass one algorithm or else pass two algorithm will be asked for 8 or 10 marks. So if you remember those two algorithms, definitely next algorithms also you can write, because all are almost the same, only minute changes are there. Okay, if opcode is equal to start, then begin, write the line to one intermediate file, because already I told you in between pass one and pass two we will use one intermediate file. Okay, so one beautiful example also I had given, like a bank counters, two counters and two employees sitting in those two counters. In between those two counters, one small window will be there, and one person will be keep on putting the slips in that small window, and whenever the person's two it becomes free, he will take those slips and he will process the bank activities, right? The same thing here also, in between pass one and pass two we will use one intermediate file, and the pass two will use the content of this intermediate file whenever it is necessary. Okay, so then read that next input line and end if start. So here also I just give you one tip, one clue, like one pass one algorithm, here also you should consider all six assembler directives, start, end, okay, and byte, reserve byte, word, reserve word. In addition to these six assembler directives, you should also consider here in this particular algorithm that one more assembler directive, that is use assembler directive. Okay, so this is new to this topic, correct? So now you have to consider this also now. And also what you have to do is you have to consider those this one, no? That is data structures, OP tab and SIM tab, that also will come into this algorithm in future. Okay, so you should keep these all things in your mind, and you just write the sentences in the form of algorithm, then it will become algorithm for pass one. Okay, so if this time opcode is equal to use, then what you have to do, if there is no any operand in the operand column, then definitely you should call it as a default block. Then again, else means if there is a operand in the operand field, then block name will be operand name. Okay, block name will be operand name, that is a C data or C block, like this. If there is no any entry for block name, then insert that block name in a block table. Okay, block table, just now I have shown you there. I will show you. Okay, just wait, I will show you that block table. In that table you will write a block name and blocks starting address and that blocks total length. These three information will be there in this block table. What all the things will be there? Block name will be there, okay, address of that block will be there, that is starting address of that block, and the total length of that block will be there. And how to find out these all things, I will tell you, just wait. Okay, so insert, if that block name is not already present in this block table, then you have to insert that block name along with the block number. Okay, block number plus plus, it means you are going to increment the value of that block number. Earlier if it is 0, then this time you have to do it as a 1 and 2, like this. Okay, if I is equal to block number for a block name, already I told you I is indicating block number for block name, then this is not a comment line. If this is not a comment line, then what you have to do, there is a symbol in the label field. If there is a symbol in the label field, then you have to search the symbol table for that label. If it is found there, then you should represent it as an error, because so two times it will not appear in a symbol table. A label should appear in a symbol table only once. It means already, if it is already inserted in the previous time, if it is repeating in your program, then you have to indicate it as an error flag, that is duplicate symbol. So no need to insert it once again into your symbol table. Else means what? If that symbol or that label is not present in your symbol table, then definitely you have to insert that label or symbol into your SIM tab, and particularly where that label is found, that also you have to mention, which block it is in which block it found, that also you have to mention, that is location counter of I. It means in which address it is found. Location counter of I is nothing but if I value is 0, then default block, location counter of default block. If I value is 1, then location counter of C data block. If I value is 2, then it will be a location counter of block C block, that is third block. Like this, you have to insert that label into your symbol table. Else, if symbol, then search OP tab for opcode. See, I told you to consider the data structures, SIM tab, as well as OP tab. Okay, so if in your OP tab, if opcode is present, then add that three instruction length to the location counter of I. Same method already what you have written in pass one. Okay, else if opcode is equal to 1, then add 3 to this location counter. Then else if opcode is a reserve word, then again add 3 into star, that is into the number of operands to the location counter. Then else if the opcode is equal to the reserve byte, then it will reserve a number of bytes what you are writing in the place of operand, then that number you have to add to this location counter. Then if opcode is equal to byte, again you have to count the number of characters, then you, based on that you should find out the length of that character constant. It may be 5 character constant, it may be 3 character constant, it may be single character constant, like only character z or character EOF or character VSMIT, like this. Okay, that many number of characters or bytes will be reserved, and I add that length to the location counter. And if byte, okay, else means what here, which else it is, if this is not a comment line, okay, that else is. So then set error flag, then end if not a comment line, then write the line to the intermediate file, read the text input line, and like this you continue the while loop and close the while loop, then write the last line to the intermediate file. Save. This line is very important. As just now I told you, the latest value of location counter, recent value of location counter of particular block will indicate you, it gives you the length of that total block, okay, the total length of that block. So save this length of I is equal to location counter of I for all the blocks. Okay, then address of 0 is equal to starting address, that is nothing but starting address will be always in the index 0, and the index address of I will be address of I minus 1 plus length of I minus 1. Okay, so these all things, what I am doing here, I am adding length to this address, I am adding length to this address, and this same procedure I will show you in our table, that is block table. Okay, just wait. For I equal to 1 to max, then the for loop we are using here, then insert address of I, length of I in the block table for all the blocks like this continuously by using this for loop, and at the end you end the pass 1. So in pass 2, the very short algorithm, in pass 2 what that assembler is going to do, if opcode is equal to use, then set block number for block name with the operand field, okay, then search the symbol table for operand, then store that symbol value plus address of block number as operand address, then end the pass 2. Very small algorithms are there, very easy algorithms, pass 1 algorithm, and this figure is indicating, showing you pass 2 algorithm. No need to panic, no need to be panic, very easy algorithms, okay. So these all things, whatever we have done, I am going to explain you here, that is, this is your block table, okay. This is your block table. Just now I told you what all the things should be present there. Block name should be there, block number should be there, and the starting address of that block, and the length address, length of that block. So block name, that is a default block, its number is 0, and its starting address is 0, and the length is a 0066. How this is a 0066, just now I already told you. So earlier it was 0063, and because of R sub instruction, you will add plus 3 to it, then it will become 0066. Okay, if you want, I show you that once again here. See here it was 0063, and because of this R sub, if you add 3 to this one, then it will become 0066. I hope you understand. Okay, so then next block is a C data, block number is 1, and address of this one is a starting address of this block is 0066. Okay, because after the completion of default block only, assembler wants to start the next block, so its starting address is 0066, and the length of this block is 000B. How it is 000B, that also I told you here, you are getting a 000A, and because of this literal of length 1 byte hexadecimal constant for output device, you will add 1 byte to this one, then it will become 000B. Okay, the similarly, the third block is C blocks, and its number is 2, and its starting address is 0071, and its length is 1000. How this length is 1000, I already told you. Now, I just want to tell you how this address is 0071. If you come and carefully observe here, C block in your program, okay, here, okay. Okay, so the address of this one, how to find out is nothing but here, you just add this length, whatever the length is here, okay, this length 000B, you add this length to this address, okay, then you will automatically get it as a 0071. In previously also, in here also, how I got this 0066, I added this length 0066 to this 0, then I got this. Now also to this address, I want to add this length. Now I will get the starting address of the next block. Now here I already told you how to get this length of this block. Okay. So this, whatever I am adding this length to this address, that same point I discussed in this algorithm here. See, I am adding this length to this address. So I am getting the target address or starting address of a next block. Okay. So this is about pass 1 and pass 2 algorithm, which is done by assembler to rearrange these all blocks. Okay, now just I wanted to tell you how to generate these object codes. One example I will show you, the remaining you should do at your home as a homework today. Okay, so if you consider the statement in line number 20, that is LDA length. Okay, so here LDA length is there in line number 20. In line number 20, LDA length is there, and its opcode is a 03 2060. How we got this object code? Just one example I tell you, and your remaining thing you should be you should do at your home today. But very you should be very careful here. Why? It means here sim tab, okay, here sim tab shows the value of the operand in a operand, the symbol length as relative location to 0003. Because how you are assembling this instruction, first you will find out the code of LDA, that is 00 definitely. Then in format number 3, NIX BPE, those flag bits you have to write, okay. And at last you should find out 12 bits of displacement. No, so that displacement calculation I am going to tell you now, okay. So what is there? It means you have to find out the address of length. So go and find out the address of length, okay. So in your program, if you find this address of length, you will find the address of length as 0003. But if you observe carefully, this length is present in which block? This is present in a C data block, okay. It is present in a C data block. It means the block number is 1. So it is not in the block 0, it is not in the block default, it is in a different block, okay. So here what I do is here, okay, within the block 1, the starting address for that C data is 0066. Just now I told you in that block table, correct, the starting address of that block is 0066. So therefore the desired or required target address for this instruction will be 0066 plus 0003, then you will get it as a target address as 0069. So if you know this target address value, then it is very easy to you to calculate a displacement, because the target address formula for program counter relative addressing mode is target address is equal to displacement plus the address, the content of the register PC. Now if you want displacement, then displacement is equal to target address minus the content of the register PC. And you know very well the content of register PC, that is nothing but it stores the address of the next instruction to be executed, okay, which will be not in the control of programmer, which is in the control of the assembler itself. And which register is in the control of programmer? That is a base register, okay. What should be the content of base register be? That will be mentioned by the programmer explicitly, not by the assembler, okay. But now I am not talking about that one, because most of the times all instructions will be assembled or translated by using a program counter. Here also I am going to use program counter relative addressing mode first. Then if it is not possible to do with program counter relative addressing mode, then only I have to go for base relative addressing mode, okay. No worry about this base relative right now, because it is able to assemble with program counter relative addressing mode, okay. So right now I got a target value here. So the instruction to be assembled using program counter relative addressing mode, okay. When the instruction is executed, the program counter contains the address of the following instruction. As just now I told you, program counter will contain the address of the next instruction to be executed, okay. Actually right now you are trying to assemble this LDA instruction, which is in line number 20. So then the program counter register will contain the address of or the content of the address of next instruction to be executed. The address of next instruction to be executed is COMP, that is compare 0, okay. Its address is 0009. So just remember, and because of that only I am writing target address minus what I am writing here is that is a content of the register PC. Then after subtraction I get the value 60, okay. So because of that only we got the object code 60 here, okay. So here you should find out object code like this. So you should always keep it in your mind, the label, the operand, the symbol is defined in which block, and what is the starting address of that block, and to that starting address I should add the address of this particular label or operand or symbol, then only you will get a target address, remember, okay. So these things, because of these blocks, you should be very very careful here whenever you calculate the object code here, okay. So please take care of about this one. One just one example I told you. The remaining things you have to find out. Okay. Today you calculate these all object codes, and today by evening you send me the object codes. Okay. So then next I go to so the next concept that is here. These all about this only. That is nothing but your object program. Okay. Now after finding object codes. Okay, object codes you will find out today by evening. Okay, so after finding that one, how to write a object program, I am going to tell you. As usual, already you know header record, text record, and end record. Same thing you have to write here. Header record. Okay, then you should write a name of the program and starting address of the program, and then you will write the total length of your program. Then text record also you will write like that only. Okay, so but here you should be very careful, because here if you observe carefully where you are generating object codes here, wherever you are continuously writing these all things, somewhere you will not have these all things here. That is nothing but address object codes here. Okay, because these all are symbol defining the sections. Okay, here no need to generate the object code. So according to this only we are going to write the object program here. So already you know this one, how to write object program. In the same manner we are writing here. So if you observe this text record here, if you observe this text record, sir, why they have stopped in only one byte of length here, only one. So if you go back and if you observe somewhere, it is a F1 is there, right? So F1 is nothing but it is a address, sorry, hexadecimal constant or code for input device, right? So it was earlier, it was up to here. In a previous text record, we used all almost 69 columns for that text record. Then in the next text record, we are starting, and in that text record, we are going to write only this one. Because from next onwards, so there is one more new, this one is going to start. That is a default block is going to start. So again, a new text record only we are considering for the next default block here. See here, the F1 is only here, and in the next text record we will start a next default block. Okay, so like this, today you just observe, you just generate those all object codes. Okay, then after that you just keep on observing, comparing that object code with these object program, how to write or how they are writing these all things, automatically you will understand. Okay, so next is very important and interesting. So how exactly now source program will be present, and how that object program will be written, and after that object program the next step is, already I told you, this converted low program, low level program or object program or machine level program, we have to load it into the memory for execution, right? So now how exactly that object program looks like are stored into the memory, that I want to tell you. Okay, so be very very careful here. You open page number 83. Okay, you open page number 83 and please keep on observing what all the things I am telling you here. Line numbers are there, these all are line numbers. Okay, in source program what happened, if you observe that program which is in page number 83 carefully, so first which block is appearing in our program, definitely it is a default block. Okay, definitely it is a default block, and in bracket here we have written one. What it is, one, it is indicating that this is the first time default block is appearing in my source program. That's all it is. Okay, this is the first time default block is appearing in my program. Okay, next, after default block, what block is appearing in your program? That is a C data. Okay, because okay, please all of you exit from this meeting, and once again you please rejoin the meeting.